Hello. How's it going? So I do something a bit different today. I'm going to play some arcade games. Yeah, I spent like last night just getting to kind of work with the racing rig. And yeah, it's kind of worked. So let's crack on. I've got kind of like a little list of games that I kind of remember when I was growing up. It's a bit fiddly, mind, getting this to work. Name's really funky about what screen it wants to display on. I don't know why. Not sure how loud this is going to be in the headset. It's kind of weird as well because if you play these games, the car is always at the bottom of the screen and it doesn't really work with modern racing rigs. Your wheel tends to obscure them. It's okay in some games, but others it just doesn't work. So yeah, it's gonna be a bit fiddly, but it's gonna be good in the end. Let's get playing. Hopefully the force feedback doesn't kill my rig and my wrists.
Get ready.
It took me quite a long time to get the force feedback to work correctly and not so strong. It basically tries to shake the rig to pieces, so with some of the effects. Not too bad. Just on the edge of the road there, and there's like a vibration that goes through the wheel. Before it was like, I had to let go of the wheel. So this came out when I was really young. I think it's 87 this came out. How old would I be? Pretty young. I was born in 82, so. 5 probably. But yeah, still played in the arcades when we used to go holiday and stuff. Go left, easy route. Oh, the desert. Not the quickest. Let's go left. I'm not gonna make it. So yeah. The amount of fiddling to get this working was quite a lot actually. I had to go on quite a few sites and forums to get to. It's so loud. Let me know if it's too loud, because it is really loud on my headset. I don't know why. Yeah, a lot of fiddling to get this work. Forums, having to go on forums and looking at things. And
get ready.
Have a look at Outrunners as well. I haven't figured that yet. The thing that surprised me with a lot of these arcade games is how much of a dead zone there is in the middle, the wheel. I've got rid of it as much as I can, but still a little bit. It's not like playing a simulator. Obviously like racing sims are pinpoint accurate. This is like kind of vague about where the wheel is. Last time I played Outrun for real, it did feel quite weird. Trucks, man. I was playing last night, Chase HQ as well. That's a weird game, man, to get set up correctly. It seems weird playing Husic Velvet pedals. It's a bit weird. This isn't even really a racing game. This is a driving game. I think that's what Yu Suzuki said. Really good interview of him. I surprise myself how bad I am at this. I got it on the Switch and I'm pretty awesome at it. But when he put a wheel in there, I don't know why, it makes it harder. Watching some like speedrunners do this, there's some hacky shit you can do in this game, man. Like cranking the gear lever to get it to go to pretty insane speeds. I don't know how to do it, but I just like don't go on the road. It's really weird. Like they can go behind the scenery and shit. Or they know where to do it. I guess it's the correct term for that. Whilst cranking on the shifter. Gotta go slow to go fast. Make it. As soon as you crash, you're done, man. I'll have one more go, and then we'll go have a look at a different game. We'll try to go the easy route. Got this working in main, and I've got it working on Model 3, whatever it's called. So I can play some Daytona 2, which is cool. I don't have Daytona USA set up. get another emulator to do that, I think. Hello. I don't know, that's somebody else. It's a bot. I'm getting faked out. Hey, though, when you think it's a real person, it's just a bot. Quite hard to read chat when you play. Not like playing Flight Sims. You don't have any time to do anything else other than play the game. This is gonna tighten up. Going to the desert.
Checkpoint.
It's a bit quicker. You're looking at kind of a minute, really. You need to get through faster than that. If you get to like 58 seconds, and that does buy you a lot more time. Said if you crash, you're kind of done. You get away with them, but if you flip, you're not going to get through. Make it, I doubt it. Ugh, just. Well, that's Outrun. Everybody's played Outrun, but I think it's still cool to get it set up on your own PC. Except the only thing that's a bummer is the screen on this because of where the car is orientated. But we're going to play another game, which I found recently, which I kind of didn't know existed, but it does, and it's very cool. If you're into F1, this is a cool game. This one I can run at full screen, which is good. I've been playing the shit out of this. This is a cool game.
Use the wheel to select and step on the gas.
You can't really play these games unless you do set up with a wheel. They're so sensitive to like the steering inputs. Trying to play it digitally is a bit of a nightmare. This is, I was reading about this game. It's really weird. Came out at a really weird time as well. Came out a year later than Virtual Racing and a year before Daytona USA. I'm guessing like Sega didn't really know how things were going to pan out, so they just kept developing this. I'm not saying it's a bad game, but graphically, yeah, still super scalar. Actually, it is a really good game, but clearly that wasn't where the market was going. Can never get that chicane right. Come on. So this was a sequel to F1 Exhaust Note, which is basically very similar but had slightly crapper graphics compared to this. Pretty slow. Another go. So you just gotta, I don't know, you just gotta get the car through there. You gotta attack it early to get through that chicane. Messed it up like twice now. Behind. Just gotta get the nose in, get it around. Doesn't really drive like a real car, just a bit weird. Still fun though. Like this, now break. That was good except hitting the gravel on the way out. I'm not gonna make it. I can do better than that. I'm gonna have another go. Mr. X. Yeah, I'm gonna have another go.
Use the wheel to select.
There's a different ROM set to this as well, where you can play as the Ferraris and McLarens that I've seen, which I might try and get hold of. I do like this because the AI does actually race you, and they are somewhat competitive. Compared to like most of our arcade games where you just start from the back and work your way through the field. This does actually feel like a race. Don't do that. Didn't want that to happen. It feels like the wheels lock as well when you brake too hard. overtake. I've never seen one of these in real life. Oh my god, what am I doing? I think they were pretty rare, like this. These super laps. Didn't make many of them. That's better. Just kind of car is just constantly understeering. That's the only thing you just got to get used to. Oh my god, what am I doing? Just looking at chat. It's like Flagman. Still pretty slow. I was getting like 55s. I don't think I'm gonna make it. Oh my god. Support that overtake. Not gonna make it. That's really slow, man. You can knock 4 seconds off that. And there we go.
Use the wheel to select and step on the gas.
Okay, we're doing all right. have like mechanical failures and stuff, which is really cool. Oh my god, you caught me. Yeah, cars have mechanical failures. Oh, you fucking absolute knobhead. I don't know why I'm doing so bad. This sounds a bit faster, but I kind of turned the force feedback down. Maybe that's what it is, I don't know. Weird. Feels like the wheel rotation isn't kind of right, but I mean, categorically told this it should be 270 degrees, so that's what I got it set as. One more go. Just feels like I can't get the car to go through the corner like it should. P1 and P2 have gone off. being chased.
Z5572, there you go.
Ah, you absolute dick.
Pretty taken out there, man.
Completely fluffed it.
At least I'm going to get to the end.
Nearly did it. Cool though. I think it's a cool game. Like, just came out at a really weird time in the early 90s. P1. Yeah. So I think I've milked that one. Let's go do a different game. Let's have a look. What games did I map? Should we give Outrun as a try? I don't think I've done the controls for it yet though. Outrunners. I don't think Outrun 2 works. It's quite a new game anyway. Okay, there's going to be some weird screen stuff going on with this. I need to change the screen. Video. Need to do the controls. Nope, not that. Okay. This can be a bit of a pain, but we'll get there. No, wrong. I'm guessing this machine had a lot of buttons on it. 5 buttons, in fact. I didn't play this one yesterday, so. And my keyboard's over here, so I've got to freaking lean over it to do anything. Okay, paddle, analog. You need to get this right. Get rid of these because I think they conflict sometimes. Pedal. Get rid of that. Get rid of this. think we're done. Oh, is there a thing? What's the gears? I think button 1 and 2 might be up and down gear. I don't know. We'll have a look. Get rid of this. Coins are done. Service. Yeah, I think the gears might be on the... We'll have a go and then find out as we do it.
This is MRS, the Mega Radio Station. This is Jay Elwood, talking to you from
MRS. Still was massive.
This program is brought to you by Sega. You're in car number 1. Ready, go!
Sounds just like racing. Better getting left channel audio. I think the second team are the way they do the machines. Wedding machine ripping your case. Some sound options, I don't know. This is another one of those games where the cars are at the bottom of the screen, so I can't really see them. Left channel audio in this. Sound. Is there any sound options in this? You do get weird stuff like this, obviously, because it's emulated. No, it's not like slider controls. Speaker. Yeah. I'm not sure what you would change to fix the one channel audio, to be honest. It's really weird, it's just coming out of my left ear. It's like booming as well. I think this game had like mega subwoofers on it. So you're supposed to have a subwoofer ready to play it. Chase HQ. This game controls weird. This is another one. I'm going to have to put this up on the top of the screen in window mode. I used to love this game as a kid, but it is a freaking pain to set up controls wise. I'm guessing this had, like, this has got a mega dead zone in the middle. I'm steering.
This is Nancy at Safe Headquarters. We've got an emergency here. Ralph, Idaho Slasher is speeding towards the suburbs. The target vehicle is a white British sports car. Over.
We read loud and clear. Over. Let's go, Mr. Driver.
You know, I just think that's how arcades were. They just had massive dead zones in the middle of the steering.
Giddy up, boy.
Don't need that. I don't understand if there's a technique to this.
Please.
Like,
oh,
if hitting him on the side was better than hitting him in the rear.
Bear down. More, push it more. Please. One more time.
Sometimes like, hit him directly in the back and you just slow massively down.
Okay. You're under arrest on suspicion of first degree murder.
I can never figure it out. I need to go Google it. This game controls like shit. The dead zone is so big on the wheel. And the pedals aren't even analog, they're just completely digital.
Over. Roger. Let's go, Mr. Driver!
Like, you had to turn the wheel so much to get it to respond. It's just nuts. I'm guessing I need to like probably tone down the wheel rotation maybe on this game. It's really weird. Let's go again. I enjoy like, I remember playing this game as a kid, like just loving it.
The suspect in our sights. Over. Okay, let's get him. Oh, bear down.
you just slow down massively sometimes. It's weird. Like that. So yeah, chase HQ. No. I need to, like, seriously trim the wheel out. I don't know what's going on with that. I think it's a different one. Tell you what, right? I'm trying to think of games, like racing games. Slipstream, that was a good one. Brazil. All right, we'll pick that. All these racing games seem to have emulation problems. This is by Capcom. This is a weird one. They don't make many racing games. A wireless keyboard or a good wireless keyboard. Seems like this one's got many controls, so that's good. McLaren out. So I'm guessing the mechanic in this game is the slipstream. This doesn't have as big a dead zone. Seems like I can actually control it somewhat. Such a weird game. Yeah, I'm not really sure how the slipstream mechanic works, to be honest. Like, lower right's got like turbo. I don't know what I didn't see that there was any buttons to use that. Past it. This is quite easy. By the way, it goes around the corners. he says as he stalls off the start finish line. Yeah, it's kind of on rails. This feels like it's on rails. You're just merely suggesting where the car goes. It's fine. It's an arcade game. Probably quite a good-looking game for its time, but... Yeah, the Capcom didn't make many games like this. It's actually quite like the real course. Degnas. Degna 2. Under the bridge. It's a hairpin. Towards Spoon. Ah, dang it. A bad game. Let's go to the loo for 2 seconds. Bloody obstacle course getting in this thing. I need to get a seat slider on it. Yeah, I know. That game's alright. Not sure how... I'm just trying to think of a list. I had a list of games I was going to play. Just thinking. What about this? This is a game that was a nightmare. I remember playing this back in the day. And being like, oh, what am I doing? This game had a clutch on it. See what the controls are like. Shifter lever analog. This game is just insane, man. Yeah, I don't think. I don't think this is going to work because I think basically the shifter on it was an axis. Seems like a kind of X and a Y axis, and it was Yeah. I don't think it's going to work. A weird game, though. Playing this. It looks like it runs alright. I think you'd only get, like, I'm not sure what the frame rate was, but don't think it's 30. I remember having the ports of this and them just being awful, awful ports. On any, like on the Mega Drive or Genesis or whatever. Yeah, if you look at the shifter, it basically was like a an act two axis, and it would record what position the stick was in. It's a shame. I don't think it just wouldn't work, unfortunately. Because the shifter I've got is, but it records that as buttons. Anyway. Oh, I know what. Rad. Racer. Really played this when it was a game. Well, when it was in the arcades. I don't know if it works. This doesn't seem like Rad Racer. That the one that I was talking about. Radmobile, that's the one. I think Rad Racer is something else. It seems like it was a Nintendo joint. Radmobile. This is a weird game. Not really a weird game, more like it has some interesting features to it. Like you have a wiper and lights. No, I don't do that. From my recollection, you'd get like a lot of time playing on it for one credit. From what I can remember. So if you're trying to be frugal with your cash in the arcade, this was a one you could play. From memory, and I think the one that came out was kind of like the same time as like, is it Lock On? I don't know, I can't remember. Is that? See how this works. Insert more coins. I don't think there's any gears on this. At least it controls somewhat competently. There doesn't seem to be much of a dead zone, which I quite like. But yeah, I do remember it being quite simplistic. It didn't have gears, I don't think. 2 seconds, I'm going to restart this. I think sure there should be gears. Like, you should be doing 173. 173 seems pretty slow for any car. I see, there's any gear shift buttons. Maybe it is right, I don't know. We'll restart it. Seems weird though. It's going red, so this was like a weird period for games. Like I said, like super scalers and 3D polygonal games were kind of coming around. Or just coming in, like Virtual Racer was coming in, or just come in. Sega were like, they didn't know what, they didn't know what was going to be big for it, basically. I think these were kind of like the 1990, these kind of games are out. From what I remember. Ouch. Oh my god, this is hard. I don't remember it being this hard. Hopeless. I might give it another go. It's a traffic jam. Let's give it another go. It seems weird that there was no gears. You can hear it going through the gears, so I guess it just does it itself. kilometers an hour isn't fast. Was it G-Lock? That's not Lock-On, G-Lock was the other game. Kinda came out at the same time as this, I think. Which I do not like. I hate that game. As an afterburner boy, G-Lock was not my jam. Oh my god, out. You can't quite tell what the collision's gonna be. Like, Jesus Christ. It's the thing with these, like, this kind of System 32 era super scaler, the collision sometimes is just not obvious. Okay, I'll put my lights on. I can tell you're gonna hit something. I remember this having a quite a large cab. It took up a lot of space in the arcades. I've been cool. Yeah.
Hey, what's behind this reckless bot?
What a weird game. Jesus Christ, how you meant to?
Yahoo!
That scream. It's horrific. So difficult. Out of gas. I don't know, is it Radmobile? Yeah, I do remember seeing this in the arcades and being like, it's alright, but didn't blow my socks off. I've got one that will blow your socks off though.
Radmobile.
Let's come out of this. Let's change. Let's change to model 3. This is a game. I didn't actually play a lot of this when it was in the arcades, but yeah, I don't think we ever had it in the in our arcade. It's messing with my OBS, I don't know why. Weird. This is a good game. We'll be right back. Not very good. These new tires. Gonna come in. Thank you. tires, man.
Your place, 16th.
Game over!
Now, list your name with your champ. S. J. N.
That's the game. That's fucking hard, right? The force feedback on this is pretty good. Yeah, that's a good game, man. I've been playing it a couple of times, maybe. Wasn't that as prolific as the first one, so you didn't see it as often. But it's still a cool game, man. The racing games. There weren't actually that many on the Model 3. You had Scud Race, which... it's an alright game. Yeah, apart from that, you know, I just wanted to go through and try out loads on stream and see how it goes. And, you know, all the technical stuff seems to be working. A few weird stuff for some of the games, but I'll tell you what I did want to play. Was on MAME. A bit of Continental Circus. That's a good game. I'll have to set the controls up because I haven't played it yet. Continental Circus. We were playing this back in the arcades a lot. 1987. Inputs. Okay. Shifter. Yeah, this was a good game, man. Hopefully, by the time I go through all these games, we'll eventually get all this set up. You know, I did quite a few last night, but not everything. No, didn't want to do that. Delete that. Okay, don't want all those controls. That's better.
Gentlemen, start your engine. 30 seconds for the start.
Thank you.
do the shrinky thing so I can see the car. So don't worry about this, but otherwise I won't be able to see nothing. See how this works. Hopefully this plays really well, because I love this game. It's quite a bit of a dead zone. Probably not going to qualify. I wouldn't have qualified anyway because I hit too many things. It's right at the end though. I gave another shot.
Go!
You just gotta take it easy on this one. Thank you.
Gentlemen, start your engine. 30 seconds before the start.
Make it. But yeah, this is a good game back in the day, man. Had like a 3D glasses thing that you could, some of the cabinets, the deluxe one had a 3D thing, so you see all these 3D effects. Like, it looks quite, yeah, because you could play it 2D, but all the things flying towards you and shit, that was really cool. Anyway, I'm gonna call it. I think I've gone through my list that I wanted to play, so I'm gonna stop the stream. Hope you have a good Christmas and New Year's if I'm not on. Cheerio.